Good morning to all of you, and welcome for this our new session of Museums in Madhya Pradesh. I also welcome to Dr. Sophia Karanja Madam here. Already in our Museums in Maharashtra session, we introduce her here. फिर भी मैं एक बार ये सभी को जो लोग absent थे उनसे ये बताना चाहूँगा कि उन्होंने अपना मास्टर्स और अपना पीएचडी रिसर्च वर्क एंड अदर कुछ कोर्सेज जो है उन्होंने मॉस्को से रशिया से कंप्लीट किए थे और यहाँ पर उन्होंने कई सारे अलग अलग इंस्टीट्यूट रचना सांसद एकेडमी या फिर बॉम्बे यूनिवर्सिटी कई सारे इस पर उन्होंने अभी तक विजिटिंग फैकल्टी के तौर पर कार्य किया है. मैं उनका यहाँ पर स्वागत करता हूँ और रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ कि कृपया आज के अपने सेशन की शुरुआत करें. Yes, madam, you can start now.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, dear participants. Thank you for your time, for your attention. And I think we can start, sir. Just a small note, you know, it's again, you know, like I did with the Maharashtra museums, it's a huge and vast job, you know, just to talk about each and every museum. And from beginning, I just want to say sorry if I did not mention, I will not for sure mention each and every museum, because there are so many of them, but all of them, despite maybe some lack of financial support, lack of staff or whatever, you know, they're still doing a so great job. And you know, if you will see, you know, even some small museum, they have, you know, some brilliant collection. You know, maybe we still don't have access to some of this collection because, you know, it's not published or it's difficult to reach some places, but you know, it's also really one of all Indian state magnificent, you know, but this is, you know, it's a middle of the India, and it's also, you know, a kind of mixture of so many different cultures, different dynasties, different religion, and this is what everything reflects in this museum collection. We can continue, sir. Next one, please. This is, again, I'm saying, and I'm sure that all of you have some kind of access to internet. Now it's an open resource, and you can see it's a official government site where you can see list of all museums. And again, I'm saying I cannot cover in this lecture, you know, in this 1 hour, all of them, but some of the practice, some of the experiences, what they offer, some of the good achievement which some of this museum done, and some important museum which may be not government, but you know, quite important, you know, not just even for Madhya Pradesh or for full India, I would love to mention in this small presentation. Next one, sir. Again, you can see some different grades, some variety of museums which we can find in this state, and also, you know, some of them have affiliation with Ministry of Culture, some of them have affiliation with some another ministries. And some, you know, they still have, you know, some national museum, which, you know, also it's quite interesting and educational. Next one, please. Yes, and this is also, you know, we have to keep in mind, but that in Madhya Pradesh, like in other states of India, there are not only museums, there are monuments, which is which have relation with some religious practice or some different another kind of affiliation. And these monuments also protected, and some of them also, you know, it's not exactly museum what we are talking about. But they're also, you know, giving us, you know, ideas that they have to looked We have to look at them like museum. And this is, you know, what Madhya Pradesh doing, you know, quite successfully, setting up some kind of interpretation center. Some of them we'll see also today. Next one, please. And the first place where I would love to stop, it's Udaigiri Caves next to Bhopal. It's one of the first place where we can see some Hindu caves, earliest Hindu caves, and all this sculpture which we can find, and architectural feature which we can find, you know, they're built, as we know, according to a script and some historical evidences, built during Gupta Empire, Gupta Dynasty. What is more important, you know, we are not talking today about just history, dynasties, some styles. We are talking about how a museum, how all this interpretation center set. You know, if you will go to that place, you know, you will feel that maybe it's not exactly museum, because it's everything is open, you know, it's open site, and there is not even, you know, a proper or a huge border or fence. But still, you know, because of all this interpretation board with so much different so different information, which is covering and which is touching, you know, this site from different aspect, will give you, you know, quite a deep understanding what is this place and why it's important to treat this place not just a picnic spot, but like important archaeological site. Next one, please. This is just one of the map. Maybe they will upgrade it, but still, you know, it's quite visually understanding what is this place, you know, which in this small map you can find, you know, all each and every cave which is mentioned, and you can find also itinerary how you can walk and see all of them, and just a small panorama, because it's not easy to cover in one picture, you know, all these entrances, all caves, you know. I will just keep few of them just to give idea what is this place about. Next one, please. This is view from the top, from one of the top of this huge hill, where we can find this this cave and this monuments. Next one. Next, please, sir. Yes, it's an entrance. And again, you know, it's if we we did not have a possibility to have to see. Is it my cursor? It's visible. Well, I cannot point, no, sir. I cannot do. Okay, it's fine. If you will see next to the entrance, there are two boards. It's again information board, which will give you idea what is this place, connection, historical, religious connection, sometimes also iconographical connection of this place. You know, you will feel that it's not, you know, some abandoned place or place which is unknown. You know, you will feel that it's significant and it's very important place. And also appreciation and understanding of this place will be completely different, because if you will visit this this site and some similar site, you will find that it's a lot of people coming these kind of places just to see nature, to have, you know, some nice place, nice time, but they will not understand the significance. And this is they're having good time, but also they can have, you know, a little education, which is quite important. Next one, please. This is one of the caves, and if we can understand, you know, it's related to Shiva god. We can see this Nandi bull, which is facing to the main altar, the main part of this cave temple. Next one, please. It's again, you know, from the same site, you know, some more board, which is important, because it's always, you know, it's a curiosity coming, you know, how this place it's made, you know, what is geological feature, what is geology of this place, you know, why they selected this particular site, you know, how they built, you know, all these small tips which is giving you this idea. And more important, you know, they're using two languages, which is allowed more people to be aware about this site. Next one, please. Yes, some more, because of course, you know, the next question after understanding what is this place, what gods and goddesses we can see here. Second question, which is arrays, you know, how they build this, how they cut these stones, how they move them, and this technology of building or carving or treating stone is always amazing and interesting. And this is again, you know, it's small information we can gather from this information board. Next one, please. Yes, it's about iconography. It's again, you know, it's just a brief information, but even this is, it's quite important, and you know, again, will give people understanding, you know, where they are, why they came here, and why it's so important, you know. Next one, please. Yes, this is just one of the famous sculptural group which we can see here. It's Varaha. Next one, please. Yes, and this is what just recently, again, it's, I cannot say when first interpretation center happened in India, but I think, you know, what, again, you know, Indian government doing, it's quite amazing that they understood now that not just archaeological museum or museum which is belongs to Archaeological Survey of India, you know, they can use, you know, for publicizing or just for keeping some monument and sculpture which we can find everywhere around the site or related to some particular site. But people need some bigger picture. And for this one, they need maybe even more institution like this interpretation center, where they can see not only something, some information which is related to particular site, but also can get, you know, bigger picture, which is including, you know, some neighbor site or some in other places. And this is what we can see in this, next one, please, in this center. It's will give you information not only about these caves, but what also, you know, earlier temple architecture, iconography, what kind of where else in Madhya Pradesh we can see, you know, this similar kind of structure and temple complexes. All this is we can find in this particular interpretation center. Next one, please. Yes, this is how it looks like. It's kind of new, and it's not keeping any original material, which is also fine. But you know, it's giving people, you know, not everyone will go to the library, not everyone, you know, will start searching for books. But this is quite visually, it's short, it's introduction, and maybe, you know, even this small introduction, you know, to this site and this team, you know, will make more people curious, and they will again, you know, start learning and discovering some more. Next one, please. Yes, next place where I would love to stop, you know, it's District Archaeological Museum in Vidisha. It's again, this is one of the museum, if we'll see, you know, that first slide. It's not a main government museum, it's a district museums, but this is, I think, what is really precious stones in all this, because this small museum, maybe again, lack of kind of financial support, people, and unfortunately, it's not only also so much public, at least when I visited, it was only me and a few my friends, you know, but still, you know, it's amazing because collection what this small museum have, it's just, you know, precious. Can we go and see next? And also, you know, next, sir, yes. And also, we don't know, but must begin because of lack of place inside of the museum building. So many monuments, so many sculptural group and sculptures, they're just keeping outside. You know, it's just row and row and row of these monuments, which they're keeping, you know, everywhere in the around the main museum building. Next one. And inside, if we are coming inside, yes, we are meeting here this famous yaksha from Vidisha, this left side sculpture, and Yakshini, which also were found in the same area. It's the two most famous monument which is found in this area because of the size, because of, you know, style, because of the feature, and many reasons, you know, why they're so famous. But still, you know, if we'll go inside of museum, next one, please, we'll see it's again, you know, it's this gentleman, he's director of this museum, and despite, you know, his huge work, and I'm sure that he's busy, you know, but he's just star, you know. If you will just go in an internet, everyone advising who visits this museum, advising, you know, just to meet him, because he will, he's taking each and every person, maybe because it's not so many visitors, but still, you know, he's helping, explaining, you know, and pointing, you know, some significant sculpture in this collection. And this is just one small hall. It's a huge museum with so many different different sculpture, which is related to Buddhism, to Jainism, and Hinduism also. Next one, please. Yes, it's again small part of collection which is related to metal sculpture, and we can see it's this is items or artifacts which is related to snake deities and the different rituals which is related to this to gods and goddesses who is related to snakes. There are so many varieties, you know. Again, we are not stopping, but just to give you, know, small idea. Next one, please. Yes, next site, it's a Sanchi complex, you know, it's again, it's huge. And if anyone visited this place, but before read about the Sanchi Stupa, mostly we know about Sanchi Stupa. And if we'll see, you know, some, even some scholars, but, you know, not so, scholarly books, but, you know, for general public or some school books, you know, it's mentioned always Sanchi Stupa, Sanchi Stupa, but it's a huge complex. And, you know, it's shame that, you know, again, you know, if you did not go, or if you will not take, you know, some more serious publication, you will not understand, you know, why it's having, you know, so much importance. Next one. Yes, it's not just Stupa, it's a huge monastery complex, and maybe not even one, you know, still, you know, it's going so many debates and so much research going around, because exactly, you know, what we have, it's archaeological and some historical evidences, but, you know, it's we need some more to get, you know, full picture, and maybe it will not be possible. But what is important, again, if we'll see this picture, and left side, you can see board. It's again, it's important. And we'll come back later to a museum, archaeological museum, which is next to this Sanchi complex. But almost every monument which we can see in this complex have, you know, small explanation board, at least, you know, some brief introduction, what is the structure about, you know, and how it's built, you know, what is significance, you know, what is the meaning, you know, some brief information people can get, you know, some people who is coming to see this monument. Next one, please. Again, this is view from this main stupa down the hill, and you know, there is a road. We can just move a little with next photograph to that place. Next one, yes. You can see it's not just about only this stupa or smaller stupa, or, you know, there are some more different structure. You know, it's a monastery complex, which is, you know, on this photograph. We can go next, please. Next one. Yes, and this is a bigger view. It's again, it's not the end, you know, there are more structures. And this is, again, it's quite important because, you know, human eye cannot see, you know, even photograph cannot show you everything, you know, it's just imagination, or if you'll see, next one, please. we'll see some maps or some plan like this. You know, we can start and using our imagination, if you have, you know, how it looks like, you know, that this is the top of the hill and this is, you know, how they placed, you know, this is important, you know. But again, I'm saying this, some museum, like next one, which is next to this Sanchu complex, yes, archaeological museum. Again, it's started like traditional museum where they kept, you know, some sculptural group and some architectural elements which they found in this site and which they could not identify, or they have, you know, they are more precious than to be just, you know, on the open sky. And also they're keeping archive of this conservation and restoration work which is happening this site. It's a huge, it's a lot of photographs you can find in this place. But also, you know, this this particular museum, you know, can give you idea that not about only one stupa, but also full complex and even beyond, you know, what is this exactly this Buddhist complex and what another site, you know, around this Sanchu also, you know, related, and how this full picture of Buddhist culture in Madhya Pradesh, I mean, now it's Madhya Pradesh, that time it was a different state, but how all this is, you know, happen and kind of, you know, evolution we can see. Next one, please. Next place which I would like to talk, it's a place which is have so many different name. It's Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Manav Sangrahalaya, or it's National Museum of Humankind, or it's Museum of Man.
आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है मैडम, आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है सोफिया मैम, आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है।
सर, कैन यू हियर मी?
यस, नाउ नाउ वी कैन, या।
Yes, it's again. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, participants. Okay, we are going to this this museum. Again, it's even huger. You know, if anyone visits this place, you will agree with me. Who still will visit in future? You know, I just advise, because and you need at least one day, because it's a huge area, and it will give you exactly, you know, idea how people in different parts of India living, because you can see. Can we see next one? Different kind of structures, houses, and some places where they're arranging for their gods and goddesses, like some sacrificial forest, or how they're arranging their prayer places inside of next to the villages or next to the settlement. It's the different places in India. They just pick up and recreated in this museum, exactly under the sky, under the sun. It's not just a closed place, it's just open hills where you can see all this element. Next one, you can see different types of houses which people built in different parts of India, and the most important, you can come inside and also you can see how they looked inside and how they decorated their houses, how they lived in their houses. I mean, some different kind of utensils,
and accessories which people used before and even using in some places even now. Next one. Yes, this is just kind of panorama, and it's not enough. Again, I'm saying it's quite difficult even to select which site to show because it's a huge area, and some of it again, you know, this museum it's still, you know, under development, adding some new structure, some new element, huge elements or huge artifacts, which, you know, will be, you know, representing some more parts of India. Next one. Also, we can see, you know, not only some artifacts, but real tools which they're using, you know, for some religious procession and also is for some everyday professional activity, like this board from Kerala. It's a particular, I'm trying sometimes to keep photographs with human figures that you can see a proportion and scale, you know, how huge sometimes all this artifact. Next one, please. Next one, this is chariot from Bastar, which is used, you know, it's not just museum exponent or some replica, it's original chariot, which is used, you know, for some festival. Also part of this museum complex, which is, again, I will repeat, it's a huge, this museum itself doing quite a huge publication, educational activities. They have a big library, which has published quite a lot of books. And they have also, you know, some kind of educational activities and promotional activities, which is giving people, you know, chance, you know, to show themselves. I mean, artists from different parts of India, like this project, which is made several years ago and showing a traditional house. And next slide, sorry, sir, next slide. This house, yes. And if we'll go next one, next. Yes, we can see inside, it's it was kind of huge replica traditional house where people, where mostly women use mud to represent different kind of mythological stories, which they're using not just for exhibition, they use for in their houses. It's a century-long tradition. And this is also part of, it's a kind of a promotion of different culture, but it's also educational activities, which is part of this museum institution. Also part of this, next one, please. Yes, it's part of this museum collection, which is also under the sky. It's called Mythological Trail. It's again, it's a small walk, and you are just walking and passing different. Next one, please. Next, different part of Indian representation. I'm so sorry, different representation of different part of India, where we can see different myths and stories, which is represented in a way of like in sculptural groups, like sculptural decor, or just painting on the wall of houses. It's again, it's not made for just this museum, and it's not a kind of project which is made, you know, just for show. No, it's this is what artists normal people did, you know, for centuries in their houses for different rituals, for some family, family celebration, or just, you know, for their professional activities like traveling singers and storytellers. And this is everything what we can see, you know, in this small part of this huge museum. Next one, please. Also, you know, part of this museum, it's a separate structure where you can find inside, where you can go inside and you can see, you know, map, and you can see, you know, small, again, photographs. Maybe it's not looks so fantastically, but, you know, it's giving you huge amount of information about different types of architectural structure, which we can find almost in every part of India. And this is, you know, it's just precious. And the next one, it's again, next, please. Yes, and this is one more house. Again, I'm saying it's just hills. And again, according to landscape, according to natural environment where this, these or those particular people living, you know, their houses place in this huge area. And this is right side photograph. It's again, it's interior of this particular house. It's from the north part of India. Next, please. Yes, next museum which I would love to touch, it's tribal museum. It's connecting to the previous museum, and by the way, they're close by. But this is something, you know, completely different. You know, it's again, you know, it's association, and it's a kind of, it's not just museum. It's really, it's kind of song to tribal communities of India, because it's made, you know, like a representation of different parts of their life, their houses, their everyday life, their beliefs, their stories. Their myths, mythologies, everything about these people. But you know how it's represented. You know, it's a completely different approach, which, you know, maybe we cannot find in any another place. It's really unique museum, and unfortunately, it's at least when I visit this place, I did not find any good brochure, any good books. Maybe it's welcome. Maybe it came already, you know, who knows, and it's supposed to be published, you know, some big book dedicated to this particular museum. But what is important, this museum, next one, please, this museum, next, please, yes, this is entrance, and next one, yes, what is important, that this museum, next one, please, sir. This museum, it's not just made about this tribal community, but it's made with their active participation, because all these elements which we can see here, of course, it was group of architects who planned this, but it was a lot of local craftsmen, it's a lot of local artists. Because as you know, Madhya Pradesh, it's a place where Gond Parthan artists, the most famous tribal group, because of their artwork, their painting. And this artist and huge family also based in Bhopal. They were participating in a concept in developing of concept of this museum, and many elements of this museum will just go ahead and we'll see more pictures made by this this craftsman. It's not just a replica, it's original material which was done for this museum. Again, you know, next one, please. Yes, again, it's just photographs. They're not giving you full idea how it looks like. It's just, you know, you're coming in some magic world and it's everywhere. Of course, they're using some new technology, like, you know, light mostly, which will give you, you know, again, some creating some magical environment. But, you know, some artwork, you know, and you can feel, you know, natural material which they're using, the same material which people use in real life, you know. This is what, you know, makes this place, you know, so special. Next one, please. Again, you know, I just cannot stop, you know, promoting and advising everyone who have chance, you know, spend in this place. Next one. Next one. Yes, this is again one of part of the exposition, and we can see it's a lot of pottery, which is, you know, it's not kind of replica. It's original material that just all this museum, it's a little exaggeration, but exaggeration to show, you know, that power, that importance of this culture. And this is, you know, I think it's quite a huge and interesting, you know, approach and way to represent, you know, this this part of Indian Indian history and culture. Next one, please. It's again, next one, please, sir. Next, yes, this is entrance to one of the house, and again, you know, downstairs, you know, I kept small picture. Everywhere we can find, you know, it's in. It's very useful explanation. What is this place? You know, what is it's all these, you know, ideas. You know, what is behind of this this place and this particular object or artifact? It's everywhere explained, which is quite helpful. Next one, please. Next to this this tribal museum, just wall to wall, it's a state museum of Bhopal, which is also, you know, occupied now. It's a new building with new good facility, but collection itself, it's huge. And they also, as you can see, 17 galleries, it's a huge museum. And, you know, they also accumulated, you know, some artifacts, not just from Bhopal or Bhopal circle, but also, you know, from some far places in Madhya Pradesh, which is, you know, also quite helpful if you want to see at least, you know, something which is happening in this part of India, but we don't have chance, you know, to go somewhere further. But still, and they recently also published a book which is which calls Masterpieces of Madhya Pradesh, which is also quite helpful because can give you idea what is the main artifacts and sculptural groups and sculpture of this area. But again, it's not enough because collection is huge, and it's just not enough. Next one, please. Next place, yes, which I wanted to stop again for some particular reason, it's Bhojpuri temple. Again, I mentioned at the beginning that in India and Madhya Pradesh particularly, there are a lot of protected monuments, and it's also in that list we can find a lot of temples, which, you know, existing or working temples or people play temples where people can do their prayers, their rituals, and they can come, you know, for a pilgrim tour or whatever. It's a living heritage temples or site. But what is important and what is interesting in this particular place, next one, please. And this is also, you know, maybe it's this is temple, and we can see it's a huge lingam, which is, you know, it's really, you know, it's just an amazing structure. And unfortunately, it's almost no, this temple did not survive till our days in full scale. You can see if you will go around, you know, it's a lot of stone and which is just laying around. But what is important, and it's again, thank you for understanding and for implementation to government, that they created, you know, next to this place, interpretation center. I hope now it's open, you know. Again, when I visited, it was just structure, but, you know, I hope they will fill up with useful and interesting information, because this temple, it just standing like, you know, you're traveling, you can see fields, and suddenly it's, you know, coming this huge, beautiful structure, you know, it's like from nowhere. But what is important, next one, around this temple, it's built, you know, on the kind of stone bed, and everywhere, and this is what they make fence around each and every sketch. They found, I mean, scholars, they found sketches which is made, and they related to this temple. Must be architect, again, we are talking about period when nobody have paper, and all material for recording was quite fragile, but they found their own way. They just, you know, repeat, or they just, you know, cover a plan and a section of the temple on the stone next to this temple. And this is now next slide. We can see and that board, if you will just enlarge this picture, you can see that, you know, on the board they're repeating the sketch and giving explanation. This is just amazing. I cannot say that I visit all places in India. It's still not possible, but, you know, it's the first time I saw that some architect, you know, that preserved their architectural drawing in this particular way. And this is, you know, quite interesting and important. Next one, please. Yes, next site, which is also World Heritage Site, it's Dymbetka. It's a famous place, you know, and it's also it's a proud of Madhya Pradesh and we can say full India, because it's a place where earliest people stay. And next one. It's a photograph which everyone doing, because it's just entrance to this complex. And again, as we know, there are more caves, but you know, it's not everything it's open for general public. But again, what they did nicely, next one, there is nothing, yes, there is not there is no special interpretation center or museum next to this this place, but maybe it's not even necessary, because its site itself, it's so amazing and taking so much time and energy, and you know, you're full of emotion and knowledge. But they kept almost in, next to each and every particular and important place, you know, some, again, small board with some explanation, which is helpful. And it's good that it's made in material which is can sustain, you know, this heat and sun and also water, you know, it's quite interesting. Next one. Next one, please. Sir, next one, please. Yes, this is just one of the pictures. Again, it's fantastic. And a few more pictures. It's one of the museum. Again, I'm just saying I would love, you know, to talk about all museum, but it's just not possible. And just one of the museum in Gwalior. Again, it's quite interesting, because it's museum itself, you know, it's one of the again oldest, you know, museum. It's occupied, you know, all the palace, which itself, you know, some precious structure, but collection is also quite complicated and beautiful, and you know, covering all aspects of Indian culture and that particular region. Next slide. It's a museum of next one, please, sir. In Gwalior, next one, please. Yes, in Gwalior. In Gwalior, museum. Again, as you know, for Indian culture, music, it's quite important subject. And it's so good that, you know, now we can see more and more museum which is dedicated to Indian theater, music culture, and some personality who themselves, you know, not just part of musical history of India, but they themselves, you know, music. And this is museum which is set up in family house, where several generation of Mr. Khan lived, and now in this place, you know, it's a musical museum or museum of Sarod. It's set up, and it's often open for public also. And the last museum which I would love to cover today, it's museum which, you know, I feel maybe it's a little sad, but I feel it's quite important, because it's this is again, it's a sad part. It's a part of Indian history, but maybe a little sad part. And sometimes people don't want to remember, you know, something which is sad. But as we know, you know, if we forget history, you know, history can come back again. That's why it's quite important that this museum, which is called Remember Bhopal, it's set up, it's not government museum, and it's a kind of public, and it's lived for some kind of donation museum, but and it's maybe not following some general concept which has happened. But this is what, you know, it's again, you know, museum which has happened in this way when now people start looking for people histories, not just official book history, and history of ordinary people who survive, who still remember what has happened, you know, 30 years ago, 20, 40, 50, and whatever. And this particular event, which has happened in 1984, and so many people died, so many bad things happened, and still, you know, people, surviving people or their family still remember this, and they want, they're living, but they want, you know, another people never forget, and they want that this is never happen again. That's why this museum, I think it's quite important, not just for Madhya Pradesh or Bhopal itself, but for full India, because we are living in time when, you know, so many natural disasters and unfortunately human disaster or disaster which is related to some human activities happen, and this is what, you know, it's also influenced people. And you know, when this kind of museum will exist and will survive and will be open and will be promoted, it will be good sign, you know, and not only for this particular state. No, this is the end of my presentation. I hope I did not, yes, there is still time if any question and whatever.
Hello.
Thank you, thank you, thanks a lot. Yes, Vikram Bharadwaji, yeah.
Namaskar. I want to ask one question. As the presenter is from Russia, whether there are any particular paintings of Nicholas Roerich somewhere in the Maharashtra Museum? Because we know that further the major important the museum of Roerich is in Srinagar, and the second is in somewhere in Bangalore. Is there any paintings?
आपकी आवाज ठीक नहीं आ रही है. इको हो रही है आवाज आपकी.
Sir, मैं ये पूछना चाहता हूँ. I want to ask one thing. Whether there are Roerich paintings somewhere in Maharashtra museums?
I did not get you. You are talking about Russian paintings, but what do you mean? Which artist? Or
I will write in chat box.
Yes, please. You know.
Okay. Please. Thank you.
Yes, please.
Yes, thank you, thank you, thanks a lot. Actually, you are showing wonderful museums, archaeological museums in Vidisha, Sanchi, and Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Manav Sangrahalaya, and other museums in Bhopal and in Gwalior also.
So many of them, yes.
Yes, and as we know that there are a lot of museums, but because of you are saying that जैसे किसी भी स्टेट के या किसी भी किसके पूरे म्यूजियम्स हम पूरे नहीं देख सकते. जो कुछ पर्टिकुलर म्यूजियम्स है जो हम लोग उसका अध्ययन करना चाहिए, जैसे इंदिरा गांधी राष्ट्रीय मानव संग्रहालय का उदाहरण उन्होंने दिया, तो इट्स रियली अ वंडरफुल म्यूजियम, क्योंकि मैंने भी कई बार वहां पर विजिट किया है. अगर यहाँ अगर ऐसा लगता है कि हम म्यूजियम का कुछ ऐसी बात की जो हम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन कर सके, तो म्यूजियम एज अ फ्रेंड की जो कंसेप्ट है जो मैंने लास्ट एक सेशन में भी बताई थी, तो ऐसी चीजें हैं जिसको हमें आज इम्प्लीमेंटेशन करने की आवश्यकता है. तो आपने बहुत अच्छी जानकारी हमें दी. यहाँ जो क्वेश्चन विक्रम भारद्वाज जी ने पूछा है अभी तो यहाँ नहीं आया, बट वो रशियन पेंटर्स के रशियन आर्टिस्ट की कुछ पेंटिंग्स के बारे में पूछ रहे थे जो महाराष्ट्र के म्यूजियम्स में कहाँ पर अवेलेबल है, ऐसा शायद उनका कहना था. आज मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि शायद वो ऐसा पूछना चाहते थे, अभी तो उन्होंने यहाँ नहीं लिखा. पता नहीं कहाँ पर साउंड की आज कुछ गड़बड़ है रिलेटेड भी. ठीक है, यहाँ आपने जो म्यूजियम देखे, जैसे अभी सेंट्रल म्यूजियम इंदौर का जो है, आपने जिस तरह से विदिशा का ये दिखाया, वो वराह अवतार जो दिखाया, सेम लाइक दैट देयर इज एन वन ब्यूटीफुल वराह इन सेंट्रल म्यूजियम इंदौर, एंड जो पहले होलकर फैमिली का एक नरसिंह मंदिर के नाम से जाना जाता था, जस्ट बिसाइड द जनरल पोस्ट ऑफिस, दैट म्यूजियम इज देयर, सेंट्रल म्यूजियम इंदौर, और उसके कैंपस में भी कई सारे ब्यूटीफुल स्कल्पचर्स रखे हुए हैं, अगर किसी को समय मिले तो वो भी जरूर देखेंगे। एक नया और एक अलग टॉपिक पर एक म्यूजियम जो बहुत साल पहले बनाया गया था, 1969 कस्तूरबा गांधी नेशनल मेमोरियल ट्रस्ट राला मंडल एरिया जो है इंदौर का, वहां पर वहां उन्होंने गांधी जी को 100 साल पूरे होने के उपलक्ष्य में भारत सरकार ने जो पूरे देश भर में जो ट्रेन चलाई थी उसमें जो एग्जीबिशन बनाया गया था वो सारी प्रदर्शनी उस संग्रहालय में रखी गई है, और उन्होंने प्राचीन से लेकर आधुनिक तक भारतीय स्त्रियां और उनका किस तरह से ये रहा, उनका सोशल स्टेटस क्या रहा, उस संबंध में उन्होंने बहुत ब्यूटीफुल पेंटिंग्स और उस समय के जो आर्टिस्ट थे उन्होंने बनाई हुई है। तो ये भी एक कस्तूरबा गांधी राष्ट्रीय मानव संग्रहालय, सॉरी कस्तूरबा गांधी नेशनल मेमोरियल ट्रस्ट का जो म्यूजियम है वहां पर आप देख सकते हैं। अभी इसका रिनोवेशन और उसका वर्क शुरुआत होने जा रहा है, जिसकी जिम्मेदारी अभी मेरी तरफ दी गई है, इसलिए मैं इस बात को कह सकता हूँ। और इस तरह से और भी कई सारी अलग अलग जगह पर बेस्ट म्यूजियम्स हो सकते हैं। हमें ये एक इस तरह का एक बनाना चाहिए, ऐसा मुझे लगता है कि विच थिंग्स आर बेस्ट विच वी कैन इम्प्लीमेंट टू अदर्स, यानी ऐसी कौन सी चीजें हैं जो संग्रहालय में बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस है वो लोग कर रहे हैं और उसे हम दूसरी जगह पर रिप्लीकेट कर सकते हैं, इफ इट इज पॉसिबल। अपनी अपनी कुछ समस्याएं होती है रीजन के हिसाब से और इसके हिसाब से, वो बात अलग है, बट जो अपने जैसे सांची केस का एक एग्जांपल दिया कि ये किस तरह से बना, क्या हुआ, इसका आर्किटेक्चरल स्पेशलिटीज क्या है, उसके बारे में वहां पर दिया जाना चाहिए था, बट हमको प्रॉपर उसका नहीं मिलता है। तो लाइक दैट ऐसे कई सारे बड़े बड़े म्यूजियम्स है जहाँ पर, या आर्किटेक्चरल प्लेसेस है कि जहाँ हमको इस तरह की जानकारी नहीं मिलती। अनदर थिंग, जब आपने ये सांची विदिशा दिखाया तो ऐसा लगा कि इट्स एन ओपन स्काई म्यूजियम, दिस ऑल आर्किटेक्चरल ब्यूटीफुल प्लेसेस आर लाइक एज एन ओपन स्काई म्यूजियम। तो ये इस तरह का हमें सोचना चाहिए और उसी तरह से हम उसको जो है प्रिजर्व करना चाहिए। बट जो अभी 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 जो सिचुएशन है हर तरफ में स्कल्पचर्स का या वास्तुओं का, उसको बहुत ठीक तरह से प्रोटेक्ट करने की आज भी आवश्यकता है, म्यूजियम्स में भी इस तरह से हमें लगता है ये सभी देख करके। सो थैंक यू, थैंक्स अ लॉट अगेन। ये विक्रम जी रोहित ऐसा नाम लिखा।
यस सर, आई जस्ट वांट टू ऐड, यू नो आई वांटेड to join hand with some previous talker who is the speaker, who is saying that, you know, it's yes, hopefully a government museum will be more open for scholars and students, you know, at least they will allow to make photograph, because, you know, there is not so many publication, but that material which they have, you know, it has to be more accessible for at least scholars people, you know, because it will give, you know, some kind of help, you know, to museums, but also, you know, people will be more happy because they have, you know, that visual material for study and to learn. This is, you know, I completely supporting, you know, that previous speaker who is always pointed this this aspect, you know. Yes, and for the Russian painter, if you will just send me, you know, message, you know, or Sarah will send me a question, you know, we can talk after this speech, after this talk.
विक्रम भारद्वाज जी का ये कहना है कि रोरिच, RORICH, ये कोई रशियन आर्टिस्ट जिनके पेंटिंग्स।
यस यस, आई अंडरस्टूड। यस नो, मे बी आफ्टर दिस लेक्चर विल डू, बट एनीवे थैंक यू फॉर दिस फैंटास्टिक एक्सपीरियंस एंड दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड थैंक यू ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स, यू नो आई एम ग्रेटफुल।
Some Russian paintings are here in Maharashtra's museums also. कुछ ऐसे जैसे भवानी संग्रहालय वगैरह है सतारा का, औंध का, वहां पर ऐसे कुछ पेंटिंग्स है और कुछ पेंटिंग्स अलग अलग और म्यूजियम्स में भी हमारे महाराष्ट्र में भी अवेलेबल है। सो थैंक यू। और आपने जो बात बताई कि एटलीस्ट फोटोग्राफ्स लेने लेने की परमिशन होनी चाहिए म्यूजियम्स में, बट कुछ लोग इसका कारण ये देते हैं कि वहां जो पेंटिंग्स वगैरह है उनको दिक्कत हो सकती है, तो हमने सेकंड ऑप्शन दिया था कि एटलीस्ट एक सीडी प्रोवाइड कीजिए, डीवीडी प्रोवाइड कीजिए, आप खुद ही फोटोग्राफी कीजिए, वो डीवीडी अगर आप सेल करें तो भी लोग परचेस करने के लिए रेडी हो जाते हैं। थर्ड ऑप्शन है, अगर ये भी नहीं पॉसिबल है आपको, तो अजंता एलोरा जैसे बुकलेट्स मिलते हैं जहां पर आपको उस बुक में ब्यूटीफुल फोटोग्राफ्स मिलते हैं उस प्लेसेस के, कम से कम वो तो दीजिए, वो भी परचेस करने के लिए लोग रेडी रहते हैं। बट सम म्यूजियम्स दे आर नॉट रेडी टू सेल एनीथिंग, वो देना ही नहीं चाहते, पता नहीं उनका अपना क्या स्ट्रेटजी होता है। बट अगर आप अपने संग्रहालय को ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोगों तक पहुंचाना चाहते हैं तो ये सुविधाएं होनी चाहिए। इट्स अ थैंक यू, थैंक यू। विनायक जी कुछ कहना चाहते हैं?
हमने ऐसा प्रयास किया है सेंट्रल म्यूजियम नागपुर में, कुछ पेंटिंग के रिप्लिकास हमने सुवर्ण शॉपिंग करके है उसमें रखे हैं, जो नामवंत कलाकार है उनके पेंटिंग्स अलग अलग साइज का पेपर प्रिंट है, कैनवास प्रिंट है।
बहुत ही अच्छा, इस तरह का प्रयास किया है गया है, ये बहुत अच्छी बात है। अगर बेस्ट आर्टिस्ट और बेस्ट पेंटिंग्स उनके हैं तो हम उसको इस तरह से पेपर और कैनवास के इसमें अगर लोगों को देंगे, इससे आपके संग्रहालय के लिए भी रेवेन्यू जनरेट हो जाएगा और लोगों के लिए भी खुशी की बात होगी कि ये अच्छी अच्छी कोई कलाकृति या उसका रिप्लिका जो है मैं अपने पास अपने साथ ले जा सकता।
अलग 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 जैसे कि मग, वाटर बॉटल, उस पर कुछ आर्टिकल जो मुझे में रखे हैं उनके प्रिंट आउट्स, उस पर स्मरणिका के की जैसे किया है।
थैंक यू, थैंक यू। इज देयर एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस, देन यू कैन सेंड इट इन अवर ग्रुप और हियर इन चैट बॉक्स। अगर आपको कुछ सवाल है तो आप पूछ सकते हैं। और आज का सेशन जो है, सोफिया मैडम, आर यू वांट टू से एनीथिंग?
जस्ट वन मोर टाइम थैंक यू धन्यवाद, हैव अ गुड डे एंड आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड फॉर ऑल ऑल दिस नेक्स्ट लेक्चर्स, यू नो इट्स रियली अमेजिंग, यू नो, टू सी हाउ मेनी म्यूजियम्स एंड डिफरेंट what people do in it, just, you know. Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you, thank you. Thanks a lot again. Here, we will stop now our this today's session. Yes, thank you. Thanks a lot. Yeah. Thank you.